Hey friends, this is Sampada Kulkarni from the channel Tech Talks. Here I am explaining you the concept of circular queue data structure in this video series. So what is circular queue, how it works, how it is beneficial than that of the linear queue, and what different operations we can perform on a circular queue. All these things I am explaining you in this video series. So before moving to the content, I would like to request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks and keep the bell ringing. Now let's start with the introduction to the circular queue. Why to use a circular queue? How it is more efficient than that of the linear queue? Because the circular queue, which avoids the wastage of space that was there with the linear queue. If the linear queue is there, then after removing the element also we can't reutilize the space, and that's why there was the wastage of space. The disadvantage of a linear queue, that is the wastage of memory space, is overcome by the concept of a circular queue. That's why here we are learning the concept of a circular queue. As it is a circular queue, it utilizes the space wisely. So this is nothing but the introduction to a circular queue. Circular queue is a linear data structure. There are different types of data structures from which the circular queue is a linear one. The circular queue performs all the operations just same as of the linear queue, and it is also called as first in first out data structure because it is based on the first in first out principle. The last position is connected back to the first position to make it a circle. That's why this queue is called as a circular queue. What was the disadvantage of a linear queue? Once in a linear queue, if it becomes full, we cannot insert the next element if there is a space in front of a queue because the rear end is not updated. After deletion, only the front end is updated. But here in a circular queue, after deleting, we can perform the insert operation as the both end are connected. Here also there is no any updation in the rear end of a queue, but as the both end of the circular queue are connected, we can perform the insert operation. How we can do all these things, that very soon I am explaining you in the next video session. Before that, let's start to know more about a circular queue. So this is nothing but a linear queue, and if I want to convert this into a circular queue, then how it will look like? So this is nothing but a linear queue, and if I am trying to connect both the end of a queue, and after connecting both the ends, it forms a circular queue. And it is the more sophisticated way to structure the or to explain the circular queue. So this is nothing but the way in which the circular queue looks like. The zeroth end is nothing but the front end of a queue. The ninth element is present at the rear end of a queue, and they are both connected to each other to form it as a circular queue. So thank you all dear friends for listening and watching my video. If you like the content and the video, please do not forget to give the comment. Here I am providing you a subscription link of my channel Tech Talks, along with the next video of this video series is nothing but the features of circular queue. Here I am providing you a shortcut link for the playlist of this video series. Happy data structuring, happy learning. Thank you.